Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel. It's Kaisley. I have been waiting for this for so long. I'm gonna tell you about it in a minute. But I have a guest here. You wanna introduce yourself?
Hi, I'm Anne, or Anneayail, one and two.
Yes. And we're doing our collab today, and we're doing a mukbang on business, women, health, everything that we could possibly talk about.
Okay.
So let me just tell you, right?
Lord.
Seriously. So when I started YouTube like 2 years ago, I was looking for like black women and stuff like that. And I started like looking into Brooklyn, and your video came up. And I was like, yo, it would be dope one day if I ever got to do a video with them.
And look.
Yo, that was only 2 years ago. I was like into it, like, and look.
But you know what the funniest part about that though is? We ran into each other last year in December on my mother's birthday at a seafood boil place.
At the boil.
Right, and I was with my godson, my mom, his mom, and she was like talking to me, and I was like, hey! And then look where we are.
I know, and I was pregnant at that time.
You definitely were pregnant.
And I had a huge old prince. You went to my what?
Your baby showers. Okay. I did. I went. I usually don't attend baby showers. That's why I like stopped. It's nothing personal. Mm-hmm. But
drop a dime on yourself.
I did drop a dime on myself.
Going to
it was, I feel like it was fake because she had the baby shower at my friend's establishment. Oh, yeah. And when I say friend, like we went to junior high school together. So we've been friends like a calm.
Yeah.
Eight
she told
years.
Me after.
Right. I went to the spot where she gave me the address. I was like, this is Chase's spot.
Yeah. And she's hilarious. Such a nice person. Such a nice person. But speaking about that, she's also a black woman that owns a business.
A Guyanese.
Yeah.
Black woman.
This food, by the way, is from Hook and Reel.
I've never had Hook and Reel. She's been telling me about this like for forever.
Fire.
So here we are. She got the fire and she got me the spicy, thank God.
I got the fire sauce. And
yeah.
It is extremely hot.
Because I'm getting
so
older. And I want to stick to the spice level that I know.
What does that mean?
Because look, when you start getting older, bro, just start not working how they're supposed to work.
Mm-mm.
You can't tolerate the same
Mm-mm.
thing.
Like That is true.
I have things sometimes, I'm like, oh, this is too sweet.
That is true.
And my boss is like, mm-hmm. That's it. Yep, you're getting older. Like, what do you mean?
That is true.
When you
because
saying, yeah.
Even things that I could not tolerate. So I feel like your taste buds also change.
Mm-hmm.
Because the things that I couldn't tolerate before, like ginger beer. I'm so Caribbean now. I was not like this back in Sheepset. Back in my high school days, I was not West Indian like. I'm so West Indian now, and it's not even funny.
Okay, I kind of can't relate because I've been West Indian the whole of my life. Like, there's certain things you can't even feed me because I'm like, this is a shortcut. We don't do shortcuts.
Yes, like I was looking at your Instagram this morning. This girl, listen, y'all guys out there, y'all better come snatch her up quick, okay? Who seasons they food from the night before now? No young girl do that, okay? And I will stand here and admit that. No young girl out there seasoning their food from the night before. This one, she's a keeper. She is a keeper.
So, you gotta make it easier for yourself, though. Just
yeah, you're right.
Everything one time. I ain't have to put no salt in that pot, no nothing, because everything was
girl,
just balanced.
I felt like I could lick the screen and lick the screen and lick the screen of damn Instagram. It looks so... I'm gonna drop a picture.
Oh no.
I am because you know I screenshot it. I'm dropping the picture.
No. But when Prince gets older, he's gonna have a problem. Because I'm gonna set the standard high for whatever
yes,
girl
please
he's looking
do.
At. I'm gonna be
please
like, no
do.
Prince, this is not how we do it.
Please
you
do.
You don't need her.
Mm-hmm. So tell us a little bit about business wise, because that's really what I want to talk to you about. And I didn't even know that you had like your own hair company until I went on YouTube again. And I was like, Annie, tell me about this video. And it was a video of you being interviewed about
oh.
a hairline with the, on the, I think it was like a podcast or a video.
Yeah. So long story short, how that actually started is when I was growing up, like my dad is more so on, I guess, the well-off kind of end. And my mom is like working class, you know, we have I have three other siblings, two bedroom apartment, you know, the typical Brooklyn West Indian story.
Right.
So getting my hair done and getting certain things was not something that I can do every week or bi-weekly like I could do like my dad. My dad would just take me to go get my hair done every week. No problem. No questions asked. But my mom, it was a different story. Yes.
Asking.
Trying to be my stepmother?
Why not? We get along fine.
I said, well. So, out of necessity, I learned how to do my own hair. So, as I grew up and I started working and had the money, it just never sat right with me. And this is no offense to any stylist, to pay someone $200-$300 to sew a weave in my head when I've been, you know, on the struggle train.
I'm not gonna hold you. I felt the same way, but I thought it was just me being cheap.
No.
I swear to you, I felt the same way.
It's not. When you've been on that struggle train so long and you have learned to do it yourself,
and you
can use that money to do other things, like $300 is a plane ticket to somewhere. Like, you can go to Florida for $150.
And especially if you have kids out there.
Right.
Especially if you have bills.
Exactly.
And especially if you have, let's be real about it, like, a lot of women and a lot of African-American people in general, they have family that they have to also look out for and not necessarily like take care of, but like also support. Like, sometimes your family member might need to borrow something, they might need, you know, they're backed up on rent, they're backed up on something.
Talking about my mama.
But it happens. Like, we don't really have, you know,
especially in the West Indian culture,
especially us, like, it's hard. So like, becoming your own boss, starting your own business and stuff like that is always a goal, I feel, of ours, and it's something that we necessarily don't really get the opportunity to do. And we don't speak about it enough, and we don't also help each other out. I feel like we don't do that at all. And like, I wanna see more of that, and I wanna also help as many people as I possibly can.
Most definitely.
So that's one thing that I started also with my property. So like, I did a lot of research, like you said, you read a lot as well. And I noticed that a majority of the billionaires or millionaires and stuff like that, majority of their assets and stuff, or like the 1%, all of them own property.
Yeah.
So I was like, that's something that I want to learn and I want to get into. So I started going to, what's it called? Caesar Flips Houses, or Flipping NJ.
But didn't you go to something about DJ Envy or something?
Yeah,
like that?
It's with Caesar. So they've partnered up. So I was always following Envy from before, because Envy had teamed up with someone that did real estate. But that guy, I felt like, was a crook. I ain't even gonna hold you. Like, you go to his class, and then after his class, he wants you to spend like $1,000 just to coach him. Like, I've already spent money for your course.
Now
why do
you
have to spend another? Right.
Right.
So I was like, I'm not doing that. So I found Caesar way before he became Flippin' NJ on Instagram, and I was inboxing him and sending him emails on through his email account. Then I seen that he had teamed up with Envy, and I was like, all right, bet, I'm gonna go to his thing, his seminar. Went to his seminar. I took like, I want to say 6 months. I followed every step that he gave, and girl, by the next year, October 16th to the day, I signed for my house.
Congratulations.
Thank you, ma'am. So as far as it being a business, what I did was I rented out all of the, every single nook and cranny of the house that could be rented. Like, if I could rent the damn driveway to put your car in, rented, you heard? Rented. I'm about
no
my
space
coins.
Left unrented.
Not even a mouse could stay there without paying rent. Okay?
A mouse?
Not even. Okay? So one of my tenants, right? Girl, he got a pigeon coop in my backyard with rabbits. I was like, you want them to stay? They gotta pay rent. I'm dead serious.
You charge the animal fee?
Yes, I charge him to rent the space in the backyard. You cannot put your stuff back there because I have other tenants. Sometimes they might want to use the backyard for events or like a birthday or something. You can't have your
pigeon
chickadees
coop
out there in the back just chilling.
I'm done. Mm.
This food is so good. How do you like it so far?
This is actually pretty good. I've never had this sauce, and it's really good.
And they sell the sauce separately. Mm. Yeah, it's like $4 a small container. So, like, if you want to make your own little boil at home.
Nobody do that.
Girl, I do. The way my parents set up, I introduced them to this and had them open. They never had boil before. They never had like a bag of food like this before.
Your parents seem reasonable. My mother, she don't want me cooking none of this for her.
What?
She'd be like, okay, so when are you gonna go take me out? You ran into me at the boil, and that's why. Because sis did not want me cooking her nothing. She wanted to be taken
but
out.
But you can cook.
I know. She knows I can cook. She taught me how to cook some of those things, but she don't want none of it.
Your mother needs to open a channel then, because if she taught you how to do that, mommy, if you watch it, call me. Let's get mom a channel.
For what?
To cook. You don't see how many West Indian cooking channels there is on YouTube now? Cooking like a Jamaican, cooking this, cooking that.
You know what my favorite one is that I've seen, but I saw it on Instagram? Terry Ann's Kitchen. She's St. Lucian though, so there's certain things that are just like hit or miss with her.
You gotta send me the link.
I definitely will. Terry Ann's Kitchen, she's dope. Like for like regular recipes. Certain things when she starts making it, but that's the thing. Like everybody thinks like, that's like as soon as you have an accent, people ask you if you're Jamaican.
Yeah. Oh
my God. It's like one of those.
They assume every accent is Jamaican.
Right. So that's the same people with food. They would think like, oh, West Indian food is all the same. It's not.
No, it's not.
It's similar, but it's not the same. So Terry Ann's Kitchen is a good baseline. So with the whole business thing, sorry. You know, we're broke as West Indians. That's life. Your parents come here for
majority.
A better life. Yeah. I mean, they're coming for a better life. There are certain things that are just splurging to them.
Yeah.
So the way that I started coming up with a hair company is I learned how to make my own U-part wigs from YouTube, of course.
Wow.
And I was buying hair from someone and I was recommending it to my friends when they were realizing that I had on a wig, and it was like, oh wait, it looks like a sew-in. I'm like, mm-mm. Mm-hmm. This will last longer because I don't have to, you know, cut up the hair and try and use it, whatever. And it was my last semester of college, and one of my business courses was like, oh, okay, you know, come up with a business plan.
That's dope.
And I just was like, okay, I've worked in e-commerce before. Hair is something that, like, that's a hobby. It'll be easier for me to make that project because it'll make sense. So I did it. I got a very good, you know,
grade
on the project. And he's like, you know, you should launch this. You know, it's not extra credit officially, but unofficial extra credit, you can try it. So I called my friend Sydney.
So this was homework.
Right. So I called my friend Sydney, right? And I was like, guess who's gonna start selling hair? And she's like, you should totally do it. Like, she was like the battery in my
shout life. Out to Sydney.
No, shout out to Sydney. Like, I really tell this story all the time. Like, Sydney was a crucial factor. I'll never forget that phone call. I was like, you know what? Sydney thinks I could do it.
That's right.
I'm gonna do it. And at that point I was 22 and I had known Sydney since I was like 12.
Mm.
So that goes to show you. I was like, all right, I'm gonna do this. And I called her like August-ish and September.
Really?
Mm-hmm. September.
So you have to make a video now to explain to us how you did that. That's like the fastest turnaround I've ever seen.
I'm a hustler, baby. I'm still a Brooklyn girl at the end of the day.
That's a fact.
I'm still a Brooklyn girl at the end of the day. So what I did was, I hired, gotten samples, gotten a supplier, whatever. And I was like, okay, this is the person I'm going to use. And then I put the type of hairs and stuff on the website. And I sold to people I know. Mm-hmm. Because at that point, everyone had seen my hair or whatever.
And knew.
So I only started this company with like $400. This $400 bought an iPad.
It
set up a domain. Yeah, let me tell you something. I am a hustler at the end of the day.
That is unheard of.
It is. So I sold the hair. I got the money up front. So half of the money or whatever was paid the vendor and the rest was profit. So the profit, I just kept reinvesting.
Mm.
And this was what? Just starting in September. So by January, when tax return time came around now, I got a good chunk of change. So I took that chunk of change and bought stock. But this is when the YouTube game was different. So I contacted a few YouTubers where I was able to just send them hair and they made videos. And I redesigned my site because I had more money to host it better and do all that.
To invest in it.
And I think like I made like maybe $1,000 or whatever, like a month or not even a month or whatever, like before that. When I did all that work, in February between getting new hair, getting YouTubers or whatever, that March, sis got $5,000
in sales.
In sales.
Wow.
And it just kept going up and up.
And you started with $400.
Started with $400.
See, that just goes to show you guys.
And no stock.
That just goes to show you. And I was sitting down and I was really thinking, like, through the pandemic, I fortunately still worked, you know, and I'm happy about that. But a lot of people was getting that extra $600 and stuff like that. And I'm like, how many people really took that money and did something with it? Like, to invest it into something.
Girl, you gotta be careful. I got cussed out when I said something like that on Facebook, girl. I got called privilege.
Bye, girl.
And when I told them, yo, y'all was at the Dior store heavy, did y'all invest? Did y'all try to make a business?
Like, absolutely. Like, you could have taken, you know, some of that. I'm be honest, I was jealous because, like, I wish I had that extra money to come in to just, like, put towards something. Even equipment. You can buy even equipment.
Yeah, a equipment camera. Is not cheap.
Yeah, a camera, like SD cards, lighting.
My camera was like $1,100 before the lens.
What?
Yeah, my camera is expensive.
Are you talking about me?
Not my vlog camera, like my actual big body. I'm talking about, like, equipment is expensive. Y'all be looking at YouTubers like, oh, why y'all charge so much for sponsorship? Cameras are expensive.
Everything is expensive. Oh my God.
A MacBook Pro with good enough memory, because you can buy 128. And 256, you're pushing it. Because if you start editing and rendering, you're going to fill
and
that up.
And don't forget about the editing program that you got to pay for.
$300 Final Cut Pro.
Right.
So,
even though it does cost a lot, I say all that to say that if you want to start your own business as a woman, as an African American, like, go for it. Take your time, start out, don't procrastinate, because procrastination is the worst part. Like, that, I feel like that's what kills the business. She knows, because I be on top of her body. Like, Anne, what's going on today? I'll be like, she must be tired of me. But I don't care. Because if you don't have, and that's another thing, support. You have to have a good support team, because if you don't have somebody in your corner, like, pushing you, like, it's hard to be consistent with things. So, like, you need support from somebody. So, like, surround yourself with like-minded people that want to do the same thing that you want to do, and, you know, like, motivate each other. Like, I call her often and I'm like, what are we doing today? She sends me pictures and stuff of what she's filming, and I'm like, yes or no, or, you know, do this, or you going to bed, make sure you try to get 10 minutes of editing tonight or something. Like, I'll be on her. So if you really want to do anything, or you want to be successful, you want to start your own business, and that can be anything. Like, she started hair, I bought a house, we're doing YouTube, I'm starting e-commerce as well. You've done e-commerce, which I didn't know that. So now I'm going to be bothering you about that.
It's how I started off my professional career.
How did you
Long
like,
story
do
short,
that?
I was looking for an internship because I was a sophomore in college, and I applied to be an e-commerce intern. I read it. I was like, okay, this is something I could do, pack and ship orders. Mm-hmm. Long story short, the e-commerce, I feel like luck is always on my side, and always putting your best foot forward. You know, show up every day, no matter what you're doing, show up every day like it's like you're getting paid $1 million for it.
Yeah.
I was getting paid $30 a day for that internship, and I showed up and showed out. And when the actual e-commerce manager, she was leaving, Pia, shout out to you, Pia. She was such a sweetheart, I loved her. She was leaving, the owner of the company was like, oh my God, I have to hire someone. Pia said that it wasn't really appropriate to ask me whatever, because I was like she didn't want to put that pressure on me.
Mm-hmm.
And the boss didn't give a shit. He asked me anyway. Like, he didn't give a crap. He asked me anyway. And he was like, okay, I'll pay you $35,000 starting January 20, whatever it was.
Mm-hmm.
And after 3 months, I'll raise it to 45. I rearranged my entire school schedule to take all my classes at night or on the weekend.
Damn right.
And I got me a job. I went from making $30 a week, which is $150 a week, to making over $1,000 every 2 weeks. And it was the best decision of my life. And then make $5,000
starting your own business after.
Right, but the thing was, I learned the game.
Right.
That's what it was, because they were making websites for Catherine Malandrino, which was a big brand at the time. Like, Alicia Keys had this jacket in one of her videos that was from Catherine Malandrino, and people would call about it all
really?
The time. Movado was a crap client. Track Phone, aka the Obama phone, was a client. Like, this is before Obama was even president.
Oh, so that was a while ago.
So, this was like a thing. So I learned the game. I learned about email blasts. I learned about static pages. I learned about Magento, which was the e-commerce platform that you used to ship orders, invoice. This, I learned the game there. And that was like the best years of my life. Because,
and you know what? That's where a lot of people get it screwed up, because they feel like they want to start their own business and they want to start today and be rich tomorrow.
No,
it doesn't work like that. Y'all just heard me say I started YouTube 2 years ago. I'm not even at 1,000 subscribers yet. And I'm still here, like, yo, I'm still climbing. You know, and I'm still learning. Like, I'm still learning everything. Like,
and she takes YouTube serious, y'all. She was watching YouTube when I got here. Did I lie? You laughing at me, but did I lie?
Shut up, okay?
Oh, the truth hurts, don't it?
I do take YouTube
She was watching on Mukbang, no less.
I do.
So she's been kind of like getting that inspiration, and that's when you're hungry.
Yeah, I do. I watch it. Mm-hmm. Yeah, you have to always stay hungry. You have to be humble about stuff, and you have to always stay hungry. Like, I don't see myself not being successful. If I do, I mean, if I don't get to where I need to be, like, I'm not going to be, I'm going to be like 99 in a chair rolling like, and we're going to do this video today. Like, yes, girl, I'm not playing. Like,
I don't like stress.
It must come. You heard? It has to happen. So, I say all that to say, like, follow your dreams and don't say start your business.
Yeah, it don't matter. Especially if you're a woman, because, like, you already have a strike against you. It might be two if you're black, but.
Mm-hmm. And I also feel like, for me, I want to show my kids that never let anything stop you. Don't let anything hold you back. Don't let anything, like, there's nothing in this world, like, my father would always say, there's nothing named can't. So, like, and that basically means, like, there is no I can't. There is no I won't be able to do this. That word doesn't exist. If there's something that stops you, all you have to do is try to figure it out. Try to, like, figure out a way to go around it, go under it, go over it. Like, the word stop or, like, no doesn't really exist. It's just, to me, when I hear the word no, it's just, like, no translate for me to how I'm gonna figure this shit out. That's what no means to me. So that's why, you know, I say all that to say, like, start your business. Start whatever you need to start. Look it up, Google. There's so many other things out there that if you don't know how to do something, there's so many ways that you can learn how to do it. Books, YouTube, Instagram, Snapchat, TikTok. Like, there's so many ways. And there's so many ways now to make money. It is so many ways now how to make money. It's ridiculous. So thank you guys so much for watching. Like always, like, comment, share, and subscribe. Thank you so much, Anne, for coming and doing this mukbang with me. How do you say it?
What?
This mukbang.
I don't know. I've heard everyone says mukbang, but then, like, you know, I try to be cultured and whatnot. And I've heard that it's mukbang.
I've heard that.
And somehow I feel like mukbang is, like, the right term. I don't know, I feel it in my spirit.
Well, thank you for the mukbang, my mukbang, and whatever y'all call it out there in YouTube world. Like always, like, comment, share, and subscribe. You wanna give your handle or you wanna just add it at the end?
It's my name. It's very unoriginal. We're gonna put it down somewhere at the screen.
We're gonna put it in the bottom of the screen, but we gotta get to this food, like really get to this food without y'all staring in my face. Huh. I'm gonna holler at y'all later.
Bye.
Bye.
So you're gonna wait, right? So I got 4 shrimp left. To end the video. You wicked bad.